money is a question that people ask me about frequently. What is seed money? Do I qualify? If I start a new nonprofit, am I going to get seed money in my first year to help start the organization? And there's two types of seed money that you should be aware of. One is for new organizations. So for most foundations, new means within your first 5 years of existence. The second type of seed money is for an existing organization that's starting a new program or project. So think about the Boy Scouts of America. They've been around for a long time, and what if they decided to start a new program or a new initiative for Boy Scouts? They are existing and they might need seed money to start a new program, but they're gonna have an easier time getting that money because they have a history of success, they have a reputation they've built, people know who they are and what they've done in the past. So seed money in that sense is a little bit easier to secure. Sometimes seed money for a new organization is more difficult to secure because in today's world of philanthropy, a lot of foundations look at giving grants or investing in an organization as just that, an investment. And in order to invest in something, they want to know what's the return on my investment going to be. And if you're brand new and you don't have a history of success, you haven't had a period of growth yet, you're still getting all of your metrics together on how many numbers you started serving and how that grew over a couple of years and the impact in your community that you're having, it's going to be difficult for you to explain to a foundation why they should invest in you. How do they know your doors aren't going to close next year? Do you have financials for 3 years that you can show them? Have you filed your first set of 990s? So there's a lot of information that kind of goes into securing funding for a new organization. I try to help people understand it and see that it's similar to going to a bank as an individual and trying to secure a loan. If you are 17 and maybe you've had a job for a year, maybe you have your own car that your parents bought you, maybe you anticipate having income coming in but you don't yet, and you go to try to secure a loan at the bank with no credit history, no real savings in the bank, no real collateral to your name, it's gonna be difficult for you to secure a loan. Now, if your parents go and co-sign with you, or it's a really small loan, or you're making an exceptional amount of money for a 17-year-old or whatever, maybe there's a possibility you could get a small loan. But it's probably not gonna be enough to buy your first car or purchase a house or, you know, those types of things. It's very similar when you have a nonprofit. When you're in the infancy of the organization, it's going to be difficult for you to secure funding from organizations, foundations, corporations, because you've been around for such a little period of time. So I encourage you to make sure that when you start a nonprofit or any business for that matter, that you have diversified funding streams, that you're confident you can bring dollars in to help support your programs and your projects, because it might not happen with grant funding in the first several years. Yes, there are foundations that want to support new organizations. Yes, there are foundations who provide seed money for new organizations. So I'm not saying they don't exist. I'm just saying there are also a lot of foundations who won't consider it until you have a little bit of a history of success that you can show them first. So be looking for that and be sure to ask those questions as you build relationships with program officers to make sure that you qualify before you take time to prepare an application and send in a proposal for funding. And I hope you have a wonderful day, and we'll see you next time on Growing for Good with Funding for Good.